In 1980, 25 years ago, I was a student in the university. I was a reporter and also had my own radio news program right across the cathedral. I remember witnessing the murders, the disappearance, the killings. Bodies of people will appear on the streets and nobody seemed to know why or who killed them. I also was a student with the Christian Student Movement, an ecumenical organization organizing refugees along with Romero. We helped the people who flee El Salvador, seeking peace, looking for shelter. A lot of people was killed in those days.
Quisiera hacer un llamamiento de manera especial a los hombres del ejército.
Romero demanded no more killings, no more killings to civilians. He demanded the armed forces to stop the repression. And a week later, he was assassinated.
Y ante una orden de matar que dé un hombre, debe de prevalecer la ley de Dios que dice no matar.
I also remember that I was in the cathedral during the funeral. The student movement had an emergency corner. Some 50,000 people from my blurry memories were in the cathedral. And all of a sudden, a lot of bullets came and bombs. Everybody was trying to get in the church. Many people died in that moment, but especially the mother of one of my friends who was trying to get in. I was a reporter. I was there. I was taking pictures. I was suffering along with the people. I remember the murders, the killings. 25 years later, I am going back home to revisit El Salvador, my people, and the sufferings. I wonder, how is everything? I wonder, what am I gonna find 25 years later?
Now we claim your conscience, now we claim your people. Even you, a soldier, can in the name of God listen to the cries of the suffering. Rise up to the
back to El Salvador, and I'm remembering the tomb of Romero in the basement of the cathedral, and I'm wondering, what am I gonna find? Do people still remember Romero? I wonder. As soon as we got into the church, my friends and I were surprised with all the people and children who were there, but more important, we found a friend of Romero who composed a song. We gave him a guitar and we put him in the bus and recorded a song that he composed to Romero, his friend.
La cuna de Monseñor Romero, donde él fue criado en el, y ahí estudió y fue un pobre en realidad y entró al seminario para ir a hacer sus primeras órdenes sacerdotales en Roma, Italia. Así es que nosotros, como salvadoreños que somos, le deseamos siempre la vida, que Dios lo tenga en su gloria, para que los pueblos del mundo sepan que Monseñor Romero luchó por un bienestar para toda la humanidad, aquí en Salvador. Ahorita va el corrido.
El 24 de marzo, la iglesia no olvidará. Otra vez bañan con sangre al que dijo la verdad.
Fantástico.